वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू क्लास 9। सो टू नवीन सर फिजिक्स क्लासेस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज फोर्स एंड लॉस ऑफ मोशन। सो अबाउट फोर्स ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड इन अवर 8th स्टैंडर्ड। इन क्लास 8 वी नो दैट फोर्स नथिंग बट व्हाट पुश और पुल ऑन एन ऑब्जेक्ट। And we also studied about the what are the effects of the force. In the same way, we also studied about the types of the forces. So once again, I will recall all these concepts in a very quick manner. Okay, na? So let us take a look about so what we have studied in class 8. Right. So if you want, you can take the notes. Right. So what is force? So force, we know that already push or pull on an object is known to be force. Push or pull on an object is called force. So we also studied the effects of the forces by using different examples somehow. So consider an object or a ball is at rest. So a ball is at rest on the surface. So when we apply some force, that means when we kick the ball by applying some force, so what will happen? The ball is rolled down on the surface and it is moves through a certain distance. That means a force can bring the body which is at rest into motion. That means it can change the state of an object. State of an object. A force can change state of an object. In the same way, if you apply an external force in opposite direction to its motion, so what will happen? It comes into rest. Is it or not? That means it can also bring the body into rest which is in motion. So two cases, state nothing but what? Position. So initially it is at rest, it brings the body into motion. In the same way, when the body is in motion, if you apply the opposite force, the body will comes into rest. So simply we can say that a force can change the state of an object. In the same way, let us take a ball. So try to apply the force in all directions. So what will happen? When we apply the force in all directions, the volume of the body is going to be changed. That means the shape and size of an object will be changes. So it can change, it can change the shape and the size of an object. In the same way, if you take one more example also, if you consider one spring suspended by a rigid support, let us attach some weight to its free end. So what will happen? Due to this weight, the spring is elongating. That means the shape and size of the spring is changes. So we can discuss so many examples. So when your mother preparing the chapatis or rotis by using dough, so what she will do? She will make the rolls of the dough. In the same way, she will press on it on a device. So we are going to get a puri or chapati. There also what will happen? Due to application of the force, the shape and size of the object is going to be changed. In the same way, when the potter is making the pots, so there also he is applying the force by using his finger and putting the mud on a potter wheel. So as he is molding it, whatever the required shape you want to mold it, in that shape it is going to be changed. Okay? And for suppose the object is moving with a particular speed of 20 meter per second. Now let us apply some more force to it. So what will happen? When we apply additional force to it, already it is in motion, the speed is going to be changed. So it may be 40 meter per second or 30 meter per second. What will happen? It can change the speed of an object. So these are the effects of the forces. So already you studied in class 8. Okay, right. Next. So next concept we are going to discuss about the classification of the forces or types of forces. So types of forces. So basically the forces are classified into two types. What are they? Contact forces and non-contact forces. Contact and non-contact forces. Sir, what is mean by contact force? So contact force nothing but the object is comes in physical contact with the force. So physical contact, the force which acts on a body by coming into physical contact with the object, that force is known to be contact force. So we have so many examples like this. So muscular force, that means when you are writing with a pen, so what will you do? So you're holding the pen by using your finger. So here what you're using, your muscles you're using to hold the pen. In the same way, to lift any object from the, if you want to hold the tumbler, so in holding the tumbler also you're using your muscular force. In the same way in running, so when you're running, what kind of force you're using? So muscular force you are using. Okay, na? In the same way, when you want to lift a object from a particular height, there also you are using muscular force. So these are the examples for the contact forces. So contact forces we can write muscular force, frictional force. So about friction also we discussed already in class 8. So frictional force nothing but what? When the object is moving on the surface, an opposing force comes into play where there is a contact exists between the body and the surface. So this force is known to be frictional force. So frictional force simply nothing but it is an opposing force which tries to bring the body into rest. And spring force and mechanical force, the force exerted by the machineries, is also an example for contact force, mechanical force. These are the types of the contact forces. And next, sir, what about the non-contact forces? So non-contact forces nothing but by certain distance forces which acts from a certain distance are called non-contact forces. Sir, what are the examples for these non-contact forces? If we take a ball and throw in vertically upwards, so after some time what will happen? The body, the block or the ball will reach to the ground itself. So here what kind of force comes into between this ball and the earth? The gravitational force is acting on it. So due to the gravitational force, the ball again reaches to the ground. When it is in air, there is no physical contact between the ground and the ball. So but from a distance only the force is acting on it, that force is known to be gravitational force. So like that, so many forces are there in nature. So if you want this example, we can also take magnetic force. So you know that in childhood you played with the magnets. So when you bring a needle nearby the magnet, this needle is attracted towards the magnet when it is at a certain distance from the magnet. So this is also a distance. From a distance only the forces comes into play between the body and this. That's why this force is also known to be non-contact force. So similarly, electrostatic force or electromagnetic force is also an example for this non-contact force. Okay, now these are the classification of the forces. Already you studied in detail about this classification in class 8. Right, next. Next we are going to discuss about the what is the unit of the force. So unit of force is Newton. Okay, so on the name of the scientist it is termed as Newton. Okay, right. So here again, based on the application of the force and based on the resultant force, again the forces are classified into two types. Okay, now so this classification is based on resultant force. Based on resultant force acting on the body, we can classify them into two types. So one is balanced forces, another one is unbalanced forces. So its name it shows balance. So balance nothing but what? It is equals to equal left and right side. So that means let us imagine one example here. Two persons are pushing the block. So one is applying a force of 10 newtons. Another one is also applying a force of 10 newtons on this. So but what is the direction of application of force? The direction of application of force is opposite to one each other. Is it or not? So is applying the force from left to right. Is applying the force from right to left. That means equal magnitude. Magnitude nothing but same value. So for person 1 applying the force of 10 Newton. Person 2 is also applying a force of 10 Newton. But in what direction? Both are applying in opposite to each other. That's why the resultant force we can write, if the forces are in opposite direction, F1 difference F2. So difference nothing but which number is greater. So from that magnitude we can subtract. Here both are same, that's why 10 minus 10. So we can get 0 Newton. That means when the resultant force acting on an object is equal to 0, then the forces are said to be balanced forces. Okay, now let us take one more example. So the same two persons are pushing the block 10 newtons and 10 newtons in the same direction. Now here what happens? Both are applying the force in the same direction. That's why resultant force is added, F1 plus F2, so 10 plus 10, that is equals to 20 Newtons. That means if the resultant force is not equals to 0, then the forces are known to be unbalanced forces. So here we can take one more. For suppose a person applies a force of 30 Newton from left to right, another person applying a force of 20 Newtons from right to left. So he is applying from left to right, he is applying from right to left. Then in this case, what is the resultant force? F1 difference F2. So difference nothing but it depends on the subtraction. The negative symbol depends on the magnitude of the force. So which is greater, that can be taken as first, and second one will be negative. So 10 Newtons. That means here also the resultant force is not equal to 0. In this case also the force is unbalanced force. Okay, na? If you observe the example 1, example 2, example 3, in first case resultant force is 0. When resultant force is 0, there is no motion. That means the object is at rest. So that's why due to balanced forces, the block is at rest or it is continuing its uniform motion. We will discuss what is uniform motion, how the force come acting on a body which is moving in a uniform motion. Okay, right, next come to this example 2. So here unbalanced force, resultant force is 0, it's not equals to 0, that's why the block is compulsory, is set into motion. And next, so in third case also it is what kind of force? Resultant force not equals to 0, that's why it is also unbalanced force. When the force is unbalanced force, definitely the object will be set into motion. Sir, what is the direction of motion in this case? So in which direction the resultant force is maximum? In that direction the object is displacing. So here two forces are in the same direction, that means the forces are acting from left to right only, that's why the block compulsory has to displace from left to right. Now come to this example. So 30 newton is from left to right, 20 newton is from right to left. That means in which direction the maximum force is acting? From left to right the greater force is acting, but due to this opposing force of 20 newton, from this 30 newton, 20 newton will be neglected. So we are getting the resultant as 10 newton. Finally on this block 10 newton is acting in what direction? In left to right direction. Okay, now so in this way we can calculate the balanced and unbalanced forces, so which are acting on a object. I think so you know about the what are balanced and unbalanced clearly. Okay, let us take some examples based on balanced and unbalanced forces. Okay, so let us consider on a block two forces are acting from left to right, F1, F2, and here F3 is 16 newton. Okay, they are asking what is the direction of motion of the block. In the same way, what is the net force acting on the block? So first we should consider how many forces are acting in the same direction. So F1, F2 are acting in the same direction. The forces which are acting on the same direction, we make these two forces as one. That's why we can write F12 is equal to F1 plus F2, that is 30 newton. So now we can draw this figure as like this. As a single force, F12 is 30 newton. And F3 is 60 newton. Okay, right. So now let us see this F12 and F3, both are opposite to each other. Therefore, F resultant is equal to F12 difference F3. So F12, it is less in magnitude, it is greater in magnitude, that's why 60 minus 30, so 30 newton is the resultant force. So this 30 newton, what kind of nature of the force, balanced or unbalanced? So we can say it easily, so it is an unbalanced force, since resultant force is not equals to 0. Okay, then what is the direction of motion? So direction of motion is in the direction of force of 60 newtons of magnitude. So 60 newtons of magnitude is acting from right to left. That's why the resultant force is also along right to left. The block is also moving along right to left. You should remember one important point here. In which direction the resultant force acting? In that direction only the block will move. Okay, that means the force can also change the direction of motion. If the force acting in a particular direction, in that direction only the object is moving. So this is about force, types of the forces and a classification of the forces based on the resultant force. If the resultant force is zero, balanced. If the resultant force not equal to zero, unbalanced. Then this is the way of calculating. So balanced and unbalanced forces. So I will give some homework to you. So let us do this homework. So copy these questions in your notes. Okay. So let us draw this as it is in your notes. Newton and 120 newton. So you should also say what kind of nature of force it is, balanced or unbalanced. So I am not giving any f1 f2 f3 like that. You can only assume f1 f2 f3. So 90 50 48. So nature of force is also important. So question is common: find resultant force acting on each block. Identify whether forces are balanced or unbalanced. So this is the today's session. So in next class we are going to start our actual syllabus, which is in 9th class. So it is a revision class, or it is a repetition of your 8th class only. Okay, right. So take the notes and complete the homework. Bye. Take care. Stay safe.